In the graph sheet, in the x-axis, mark for distance in meters. In the y-axis, mark for resistance in ohms. So write the scale respectively. And these were the readings we obtained when we did the experiment in the outside. So let us mark the points. At 1.5 meter, we had 7.5. So this will be the point at 1.5. So similarly, mark the rest of the points. So once all the points are marked in the graph sheet, in a freehand use a freehand drawing and connect all the joints from 0 till the 20th ohm. Once all the dots are connected, make a note of a small calculation where you need to know and calculate 100% of D, that is currently the capital D is 10 meters. So 100% of 10 meters is 10 meters itself. 75% of D is 7.5 meters. 50% of D, 50% of D is 5 meters. And 25% of D is 2.5 meters. So all of those points are also marked in the graph. And extrapolate the points between 25% of D and 75% of D. To calculate our average, we have to consider the points that fall in between these regions. So we have the points. If you look at the tabulation column, we have the points between 25%, that is 2.5 meters and 7.5 meters. So these are the points that fall in between this region. So our average is given by the sum of the points that fall in between these regions, that is 8 plus 8.68, 8.6 plus 9.2 ohms plus 12 ohms. Divided by, what is the number of average that we have taken? 1, 2, 3 and 4. So when you calculate this, you get the final value of the resistance offered by the electrode point E. So as per the calculation and the graph, you can see that our average will fall in between, will be the average of the points that fall in between 25% of D and 75% of B, and we have taken the average of all those and calculated it. We get our average as 9.45 ohms. That means to say the resistance offered by the electrode E at that given point is 9.45 ohms, which is way too tolerable for the system to handle any sudden currents that flow into it. Thank you so much.